days have come and gone again, my muggle friends. The time has come, the work is done, and now we face the end. I remain your humble host, the one known as Funky Monkey. And what a long, strange trip it has been. We have seen the boy wizard Harry Potter grow from confused and wondrous child to focused, unwavering adult. And so we bring this tale to its inevitable conclusion in the Deathly Hallows Part 2. Released in July of 2011, The Deathly Hallows Part 2 returns to Hogwarts, where a final battle against the Dark Lord himself and his followers is in the offing. Harry and his allies go on a Horcrux rampage, but to destroy them all will cost them more than they could imagine. So grab your wands one final time and prepare to take your place on the battlefield as we face the final curtain in The Deathly Hallows Part 2. We open this half chapter in a safe house. Harry has a plan, which would go predictably pear-shaped, but for an unforgivable intervention.
Imperium.
And so our heroes reach the next Horcrux. But goblins are tricksy creatures at the best of times, and our heroes have to improvise their own escape. Well, Hermione was right about one thing. It was a rather mad idea, riding a dragon to safety. Still, desperate times and all that, eh? And so they apparate to Hogsmeade Village, which would also go pear-shaped, but for another Dumbledore.
You bloody fools, what were you thinking coming here?
Aberforth Dumbledore grudgingly agrees to help our heroes.
Neville, look, you don't like hell, I reckon.
And Neville Longbottom leads them to a hero's welcome. And when new headmaster Severus Snape summons a late assembly, our hero has a few choice words for the new headmaster.
You still have a bit of a security problem, headmaster.
Who is swiftly driven out by Professor McGonagall. But we haven't seen the last of Severus Snape just yet, my muggle friends. Oh no. And so, Luna leads Harry to the one person who can find the lost crown of Ravenclaw.
You listen to me right now!
Merciful heavens! He broke Luna Lovegood!
Then again, I suppose we all have our breaking points. This was just hers. Down in the Chamber of Secrets, Ron and Hermione destroyed their Horcrux. Which is more than a little frustrating for the Dark Lord. And so the Battle of Hogwarts begins. Harry finds the lost crown in the Room of Requirement, just as Draco Malfoy finds him.
Place on fire!
And Harry shows his mercy once more. Harry Potter is a better man than I, for I fear I would not be so magnanimous as to save my enemies from themselves. And just in time, the lost crown of Ravenclaw is cleared of the Horcrux. But then we discover a sticky situation for Severus Snape.
It answers to you.
But only I can live.
But there's life enough in Snape to reveal the truth to our heroes. Stay a while, my muggle friends, as I relate to you the tale of Severus Snape. For you see, it was Severus Snape that had always loved Lily Evans. Lily Evans, that is, who became Lily Potter. James Potter, however,
was not too keen on Severus Snape, and the feeling was mutual. And when Harry was born, and throughout his life, it was Snape that protected him. Yes, my Muggle friends. Shocking as it may seem, Harry himself is a Horcrux for the Dark Lord.
And so our heroic Horcrux goes to the Forbidden Forest. And his fate. But Harry awakes in limbo and converses with Professor Dumbledore one last time.
Mad Andy was unavailable for comment. Damn anti-accio enchantments.
Back in the land of the living, Voldemort declares victory. But it turns out to be premature, as Neville Longbottom buys our hero all the time he needs.
They didn't die in vain.
And the battle continues. Voldemort and Harry tussle across the length of the castle, and just when all looks lost, Neville comes in for the save. Thus ends the life of Tom Marvolo Riddle. And so we close this chapter, and the tale at last, 19 years later, as our matured mage and his friends send their own children off to Hogwarts.
And so, my Muggle friends, we come to the end of the Deathly Hallows Part 2. And with that, we come to the end of the Deathly Hallows. And furthermore, we come to the end of the tale of Harry Potter. And yes, lock, stock, and barrel, we shall deliver this saga safely once more unto the House of Love.
This is the payoff we've been waiting for. The big war movie. Explosions, death, and the end of Voldemort. And it wouldn't have been anywhere near as satisfying if we hadn't had 7 whole movies before it. Yes, some of them were uneven, cringeworthy in places, tense sometimes, but the light always shone, even in the darkest moments. As the shortest of the movies, this one is only slightly less jam-packed. The pace is plentifully brisk, the tone hopeful, as one by one the Dark Lord's defences crumble. And though it's always darkest before the dawn, when the dawn comes, it shines out all the clearer.
Thus do we bring this episode and the Potterthon to a close. And you may have noticed, I'm not wearing my ring today. Yes, I've decided to wind down the magic and go back to just being me. So that's it for 2012. Join me in 2013 for more fun, more frolics, and more silliness. But for now, there's still magic enough for one last spell. Spellcasting! Heroes! HEROES!
Thank you.